Alright guys, we're back for another episode of Project Hospital, and I was just trying to figure this guy out. He had angina pectoris or myocardial infarction. I had him slated for an ECG and a blood test while I was waiting for the CRP, and then the CRP came back and it was angina pectoris, so he was already admitted, sadly, so now he needs nitrates. But lots of patients coming in here. What are these two doing? Nail fungus. Antifungal. Uh-oh. Oh, how long have these people been here? Got thrombophlebitis, which is a cardiology problem. Okay. These people are stuck. Because they shouldn't be here, they should be in a bed. Oh no, they're getting called in. Oops, x-ray lower limb. Oops, wow. That was quick. Why is the antifungal cream coming off for these guys? Let's go. I need to cancel their admission. I really should stop doing this physical exam because it's not necessary. Is he gonna work this time? These people are bugged. Does that work? Yes. Anyway, so what we're trying to do is treat 30 patients in the emergency and reach prestige 80 at any specialized department. That's going to be difficult. Have zero total loan though. Oh, that's right. We're going to build the new department. So just checking my objectives there. I don't need it. Golfer's elbow. Apparently you can only have golfer's elbow if you have finger numbness, hand weakness, and tenderness, and fever. Okay. So, internal medicine. Internal medicine office. Okay, I'm just going to do this one. Needs a desk. And it needs a printer. PC. Oh, I put the printer in the wrong place. the office chair. And then it needs an exam table. Why is this office so big? No, I don't want to put that there. I need a wall, actually. What color are these guys going to be? Brown. Let's have... And we just need this one for now because we haven't got the rest of the departments. And back to what we're going to build in here. It needs an exam lamp. Oops. It needs an eye test. Cabinet. With an audiometer. Oh, we also need a CRP scan. And the good old disinfectant alcohol based hand rub. Oh, we need another one for a spirometer. Chair for the patient. Man, that office is really big. I think it's just big just to take up the space. Oh, we need floor. Brown floor. And parking elevators we haven't ventured into yet. Alright, what else do we need for this department? It's an internal. Oh, it needs a door. I was like, what? I've got one of these. Oh, we don't have an internal medicine waiting room. Well, this is going to be it. Now let's just make it there. I'll have to change that when I build that. Okay. We need staffing for day and night. So let's just go with one day doctor. He's going to be a specialist in the day. And then we'll see how we go with needing... Yeah, we do need a night doctor. Resident. Get the cheaper chick. Okay, and then... He's got a leg contusion. Needs numbing ointment. And then, oops. Oh, what's this? Is that a waiting area? Oh, is this meant to be a corridor? Yeah, we'll leave it for now. was I building the internal medicine ward? Nowhere. I have no more space for a ward. Can make it here. Thank you. Diagnostic unit. Dun, dun, dun. So we need a doctor's office. This, we're gonna put it on this side. And then we need a nurse's office. Like that. We need for the internal medicine admission. No, I'm in the wrong thing. Nurses station, on call room, regular ward, and a HDU. Here. Watch this, guys. We're going to do double. Should I leave space for the cleaning closet? I don't think so. It's in the wrong place. Alright, there we go. HDU and regular ward and HDU. What else do I need? HDU, nurses station, on call room, diagnostic unit. On the wrong side for that diagnostic unit. It's blocked by another object. Yeah, put that there. Equipment. Oh, it needs an audiometer and a spirometer. Let's see, is a corner cabinet. Seriously. can't put anything on a corner cabinet. Whatever, it's artistic. Nope. Can't put that there. Now we need cardiography unit. Special procedures unit. Gonna leave cardiography because I can get that at cardiology. Oh, what am I doing? Foundations. And then walls is what? There's that lovely brown unit. Oh, we can do lino. Are the walls? No. Brown on the bottom and white on the top. This one. And brown fall. Oops. I just did the wrong thing. I can only do the last action. I knew I was doing the wrong. Oh wait, the walls all have to be there. And this wall. Just to make it look right. Yep. Alright, now it's floors out here, which are red. A red strip. Foundations. I was like, wait, if I run out of money, am I going to have to get a loan? Not yet. Let's just put this wall in. Yep, that's correct. Zenzi floor. Zenzi remove wall. Before I forget, and another white tile floor. Kill. Oh, these need to change. Dark lino brown. And these walls. Oh my goodness. Brown on the bottom, is that it? Yep. And that means we need to change the doors. Well, this room might not be big enough. What? I'm trying to make a... I'm trying to make an operating room in the tiniest space ever. Instruments table. Is that the last spot? Yep, we're gonna have to make this a bit bigger, aren't we? Instruments. I can't believe I made the world's tiniest, oops, operating room. Special procedures unit. And we need staffing. We need an internal medicine doctor. And we need surgery. Do they need a nurse in there? Nope. We need the resident and the consultant fellow specialist. Then the night shift needs a resident. Did I do the right thing for the daytime? Yeah, let me just check. I need someone in anesthesiology. No, she's got anesthesiology. Yeah, okay. Okay. Now we need nursing that has nurse plus surgery. And how many do they need? Just one. No way, we only need one nurse. She's got medical surgery. Then we need a nurse at night who's got medical surgery. Oh no, it's zero. We need zero. Let's see. Get Beardy McBeard overnight. Okay, is that enough? Am I good to go? Alright. You've got HHD. You need a diet modification. And what? Where is she? Why can't I admit her? Okay, do an ICU admission. I think it's because cardiology is full. No? So they've got beds. Whatever. She's going to ICU now. ICU would hate that. They'd be like, this is not an appropriate ICU admission. Am I good on internal medicine? I didn't get a message to say internal medicine is now available. But it appears to be fine. He's got such a big office. Let's put a plant in there. Of arteries. Let's put a poster outside too. Oh crap, I forgot to do the chairs. Shouldn't need that many chairs. Four is enough. Yep, you've been treated. Give me $460. Let's wait for our first intern. Oh my goodness, these people are still here. Uh-oh, what'd that do? No idea what they're up to. What's going on with my game? Where is that guy going? He went to the toilet. Okay, he's okay. He just wanted to do a wee. Money coming in. Oh, she's here. We go. First internal medicine patient. Oh crap! I forgot to build one of those things. Meniere's disease or PE? Thorax percussion is pretty good. Blood pressure is good. Ear exam, then audiometry. Oh, there goes the ambulance. Holy cow, dude, you're taking too long. Oh, there it is. Let him do it. And he found Meniere's disease. Diuretics, eardrops, antioxidant, anxiolytics. $240. Oh, ciguatera. Fish poisoning, also known as ciguatera, is a foodborne disease caused by ingestion of fish flesh contaminated by certain toxins. He went straight to blood draw. The frick. Oh, because he needs admission. And mannitol. Why is he doing a blood draw? Anything in the emergency department? What did we get? Oh. Someone with a leg injury. Into Ziddy Sus. Why is it going straight to differential? You need a lower limit, right, lady? That's my Ciguatera patient. Two at once? Uh-oh. Someone who can't talk. Oh no, we need the X-ray and the CT brain. Let us hire a new staff member. Ready, guys? I'm going out on a limb here. Wait, not that. We'll take Susan Brown. Just so that I can order a CT brain here. Does she need CT angiography? Or just... No, because it sounds like it's traumatic. Richard Moore with his Ciguatera, aka food poisoning. I have to look that up because I don't know why it needs mannitol doses. To fight intoxication by ciguatoxin. There's a little bit of mannitol in... might have been a bit hasty to hire this lady because I don't really need it. I only need it very rarely. Anyway, yes, Ciguatera. Mannitol is used to reduce intracranial pressure when there's a bleed. Just give a bag of mannitol. Also, it's in IV paracetamol. A little bit. That's why IV paracetamol can drop your blood pressure a little bit. Bit of trivia. How's internal medicine going? Did you get any more patients? Breathing problems. Well, poison ivy rash. Oh, we're getting all the... Oh, he's aggressive. We're getting all the internal medicine diagnoses now. Poison ivy rash is an allergic reaction to resin. Urushiol is like a leaf, stems and roots of poison ivy, oak, and sumac. And he's going to give me $160. Fractured tibia, waiting for transfer to ward. Wait, where'd this person go? Still in CT? Yep. Oh crap, CT showed nothing. Well. Now what? They're gonna do an ear exam. Thorax percussion, as usual, is pretty good. I suppose I rushed her off to imaging without getting the full information. We can get a quick CRP. Kidney stones. It's showing nothing. 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 Oh crap, there's another ambulance. Uh-oh. Okay, he's got IHD. Normally I do this stuff on regular hospitalization, cardiovascular surgery. But I'm thinking I'm just going to let those doctors figure it out over there. Like, see, he figured out. He's admitted with kidney stones and he's chopped away with erythropsy. Crap, I lost my patient who's having this one. Oh, it was CO2 poisoning. Because of SATs? No, because of ophthalmoscopy. Okay. Carbon monoxide poisoning occurs from inhaling too much carbon monoxide. She's going on HTU and having oxygen therapy. ICU lady, paying for ICU, doesn't really need it. Oh, which means both my rest of the space are empty. Awesome. Oh, he's got TB. He's coming with a diagnosis already. He's going to be admitted. What is he? HTU. In the room with everyone else. He needs a single room. He needs a single room with isolation. Since there's not much happening now, we should probably check our wards, make sure everyone has a diagnosis. Two kidney stones, exocrine, pancreatic insufficiency, and intestinal nephritis. Oh, and the patient here. Oh, he's the hip osteoarthritis patient. Heart failure. Shoulder. Bed required for treatment. Osteomyelitis. Complicated femur fracture, simple fracture of tibia, open fracture. Oh no, why are they all in HDU? Or is this the normal ward? Why are they in HDU? What for? We've got this one lady in HDU with CO2 poisoning and ciguatera. And how many patients did I do? 33, but not all in emergency. The frick are they doing a chest x-ray for? I guess just to check how he's going. Palpitations. Doesn't she need oh crap. found an irregular heartbeat. Now she's on beta blockers. Oh, found all the symptoms. So it was the heartbeat that was causing her to collapse. Now she's in ICU. She can go back to the ward now. She's had her beta blockers. What's this section for? Oh yeah, there is stuff there. Cardiography. And sonography. Surgery available right now, lady. He's had his surgery. Maybe I can treat other symptoms. NSAIDs. Stoma cheeks, analgesics. He's got hidden symptoms. Let's put someone in angio and see. Put Beardy McBeard over here and do. They're still defibrillating him. And take him there, take him for an echo. I guess because he's deteriorating. LDL and hemoglobin. Diet, diet, rest, recommendations. Why not? Give him everything. You're going to give recommendations to a dude who's just been moved to HD after having a heart attack. Good one. Uh-oh. Holy cow, okay. Let's try temperature. That'll rule out lactose intolerance. It's a stool analysis. Oh, there's no temperature. Okay, admit. having diarrhea, we sample your poo. And if you're doing a blood test, maybe you should do a CBC. Serologic sampling anyway. Oh no, jeez. What? She's not even in it. She's got a tension near my thorax. Thoracentesis. What's going on in this corridor? Doesn't appear to be getting cleaned. It's not. No, it is. Oh well. Can HDU do a thoracentesis? Looking in the examinations, but it's a treatment. Thoracentesis is not for thought tension though. Thoracentesis is for pericardial effusion. Excuse me, I'm just gonna make use of your tiny operating room. Is well, it's a pericardiocentesis. Let's just go in daytime so they can do the surgery on him now. Failures. Oops. Didn't know he had a tamponade. Crap. Maybe because should have done thorax percussion, it might have showed it. Whoopsie, this hospital is horrible. Alright guys, I think that'll do us here. We did an episode, we got our internal medicine open, we fiddled around with some patients. Let me know how it went, what your thoughts are, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now.